This is your boy James over at Expecto Go, bringing you guys the latest and greatest AYCC Night content. And today, we're here to go over the slate of events for the month of July. Can you believe it's July? And Harry Potter Wizards Unite. And this is going to be a portion of the events officially announced. We got some other events looming in the horizon for the month, but these are the ones we're going to announce so far. So if you don't want to miss any announcements or news when it drops officially from the Harry Potter Wizards Unite team, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss a thing. So yo, without further ado, yo, let's dive right into the slate of events so far in Harry Potter Wizards Unite. So early access to this information is provided by WB and Niantic, so shout out. And the infographics are courtesy of the NDA team, helping out while Orange Wizard is away. Now the details for the slate of events for the month of July in Harry Potter Wizards Unite so far are as follows. We have Witches and Wizards. Harry and Hermione's quest to restore Ron's memories continue with a search themed around their second year. This July, keep an eye out for the following. So the very first event is one that's going to be happening today as this video is being released, and that's going to be the third adversaries event, Gilderoy Lockhart's Adventures. And you guys already seen the task, you guys already know what to expect, but yo, I'm very hyped about this because I like the creativity with the task. And so I'm not gonna be playing through it as much, but I will be completing it. And this is a step in the right direction in regards to switching things up, mixing things up, in my opinion. But the details are as follows. Adversaries resembling Gilderoy Lockhart are on the attack. Bring this dangerous situation under control and get a glimpse into the Unforgivable's reasons for unleashing adversaries. This happens June 28th through July 1st, 11 a.m. Pacific time start and finish. And you guys, just cut and dry adversaries event. But the key thing is, especially after the big reveal with the Unforgivable Truth Part 2 in regards to the mole, looks like we're gonna be getting some insight into why the Unforgivable released adversaries. That is very cool. That is very exciting. We'll see what Harry is dreaming. So that's the first event. So the next event happening as soon as that ends is one all you guys are hyped about, and the ones your boy is very hyped about. And this is a week-long event. And this is going to be the Dragon event. And the Dragonologist Delight is what it's officially is called. And the details are as follows. Look to the skies as you combat a surge of dragon oddities and return dragon egg fragments from Port Key portmanteaus. Plus, look out for an additional SOS Task Force challenge. July 2nd through July 8th, 11 a.m. Pacific time, start and finish. And this is going to be a dragon event, and everybody loved the last one, and they're bringing this back. Be on the lookout this week for the details dropping. Be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss it. So as soon as that's done, that weekend, we have our community day, and it's going to be on a Sunday. And what's so cool about this one is, it's all about wizarding challenges. So details are as follows. Strategically complete wizarding challenges to complete bonus fragments, bonus wizarding XP, bonus challenge XP, and spell energy. Now it sounds the same, but there was a slight uptick in regards to all the challenge XP and the wizarding XP during this type of event. Last time I believe was in, I want to say March. So that being the case, I'm very excited about that. Very excited about joining my local community and playing with them, finding a sponsored fortress, whether it's AT&T or Simon Malls, and kind of hanging out there and grinding some extra challenge XP and wizarding XP, those bonuses you get from a sponsored fortress. So definitely looking forward to that. Nightbus is going to be popping. We're going to have our weekend Nightbus sessions per usual in our Discord. Links will be in the description if you guys want to join and hang out with the crew. And that's going to be July 11th. Again, a Sunday, midnight to midnight, your local time, wherever you are in the world, per usual. Then we have another adversaries event. This is technically the first one for the month of July because the other one started at the tail end of June. But nonetheless, adversaries event one reads, ready yourself for battle as you confront a surge of every adversary we have faced so far. July 14th through July 21st, start and finish 11 a.m. Pacific time. So you don't have to worry about EDMs boosting everything because everything is going to be out there. But nonetheless, if you need to work on any of these cats, hopefully you get good RNG. And yo, that's it. That's going to be it. Now, the moon phases for your oddities, the Death Eater and the Werewolf, we got the new moon July 7th through July 11th. That's where you see the Death Eater. And then, of course, the Werewolf, the full moon, that's going to be July 22nd through July 26th in game. So be on the lookout for those. Great ways to get some XP, get some gold gifts, especially if you're grinding them. So yo, it's always a good time. Oddities are always clutch. Less spell energy, you already know the routine. So the big thing at the bottom of this infographic, and I'll have the infographics linked below if you guys want to copy, quote unquote, the rest of July's calendar will be announced at a later date. Harry Potter Wizards Unite team. So we're missing the Brilliant events and the 1920s event promised by Lola back in June. Are we going to get these events and have them run into August? Are we going to get one Brilliant event? I don't know. We know the Brilliant event is centered around the second year, according to the description at the beginning. So if that's the case, I'm hoping we only get one Brilliant event and we just give us something huge with this 1920s registry page slash event. So I'm looking forward to new page, looking forward to the mechanics and the features and introducing it to you guys officially with the task and all that information. So I'm pretty excited. I'm pretty hyped. And again, it looks like it's going to be another packed month. Yo, go through the list. You're like, yo, I might focus on that one and maybe skip the other ones, especially until we get announcements for the new page for the 1920 or even the Brilliant event. So keep that in mind. But yo, that is going to be it. That is going to be it in regards to the details for the list of events for the month of July in Harry Potter Wizards Unite so far. So yo, what do you guys think? How you guys feeling about the slate of events so far? What are you guys going to be skipping? What are you guys going to be focusing on so far? Comment below, let me know. Let's talk some Harry Potter Wizards Unite. The anniversary event was a good way to end year two, and this is the start of year three. So I'm very excited, I'm very enthused, and I'm looking forward to what's to come in Harry Potter Wizards Unite, particularly the 1920s and the Dragon Pages specifically. But nonetheless, I'm out of here. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to, again, make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell, follow us on our various forms of social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Discord. We'll be posting the infographics, the video links, all of those when the information drops, particularly with the new pages and with the Dragon event. A lot to look forward to, in my opinion, once we get the green light to release it. So nonetheless, yo, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys have a good start of your week. I'll see you in the next video. Until